Hello everyone! My name is Tianline and today we talk about the group dungeons in the Elder Scrolls Online. Also, I will explain what are the Undaunted Pledges, how you can join a group for a dungeon, and which monster and dungeon sets you can find. First, I will try to explain what are group dungeons. Each of the main zones have one group dungeon. There are also two dungeons in the Imperial City DLC and two dungeons in the Shadow of the Hiss DLC. These dungeons are designed to be explored with a group of four players. The enemies in these dungeons are more difficult than the enemies in the public dungeons. There are normal and veteran versions available for each dungeon. The veteran versions use the same map and bosses, but the enemies have more health and deal more damage. So the veteran versions are much more difficult, but you have the chance to get higher quality loot. Each dungeon has a quest and its own storyline. Some of the dungeons even have a version 1 and a version 2 storyline. These take place on similar maps to each other, but with different enemies and mechanics. The quests in version 2 dungeons continue the storyline established previously in version 1. If you discovered a dungeon already, you can travel there direct via a way shrine. When you enter direct a dungeon, you can choose between the version 1 and version 2 of the dungeon. Now we will talk about the Undaunted Pledges. You don't need these pledges to do a group dungeon, but since the Undaunted Daily Pledges will send you anyway into a group dungeon, it does not hurt to take a special reward from the Daily Undaunted Pledges. When you reach level 45, you will receive per mail an invite to join the Undaunted. Travel to the Undaunted Enclave of your Alliance. You can find the Undaunted Enclave in your Alliance capital city. In Gradwood in Eldenwood, the Undaunted Enclave is south of the Eldenwood Way Shrine. In Stormhaven, the Enclave is west of the Waywest Way Shrine. For the Ebenheart Pact, the Undaunted Enclave is outside of Mournhold, not far away from the Mages and Fighters Guild. First, you have to sign the Undaunted Tome, and then you will get introduced to the three quest givers for the daily Undaunted Pledges, and you will receive your first Undaunted Key. You have then the opportunity to challenge yourself in the daily Undaunted Pledges, which will send you to different group dungeons in Tamriel. These group dungeons are made to play with a group of four players. For example, one tank, one healer and two damage dealers. There are different ways how you can find a group for the dungeons. Many people look via the zone or guild chat for a group. You will see messages like this. That means someone is looking for one more damage dealer for the veteran Tempest Island dungeon. Or you can use the Dungeon Finder, that will group you with random people. When you press P, the interface for the group and activity finder will open. On consoles, there is an extra menu point activity finder. First, you should choose what role are you playing. A tank, a healer, or a damage dealer. On the top right, you can then choose different options. The random dungeon is a good option if you want to earn some extra experience. Maybe you are even lucky and you will get the daily dungeon you need. Otherwise, choose specific dungeon and then you look for the dungeon you need to complete and decide on which difficulty, normal or veteran, you want to complete the pledge. You can earn different rewards depending on the chosen difficulty. For the normal dungeon you will get as a reward one key. The veteran version of the dungeon will reward you with one key and a monster mask of that dungeon. If you do the hard mode of the veteran dungeon, you will receive two keys and the monster mask. That means you can acquire a maximum of 6 keys per day if you finish all 3 dungeons on veteran hard mode. With this pledge key, you can open one of 3 chests at the Undaunted Enclave. There is one chest from Majal Ragat, one from Glirion the Redbeard, and one from Urgalak Chiefbane. Each chest will give you from a specific dungeon pool the monster shoulder piece. So if you are looking for a shoulder piece from a dungeon which Majal offers, you have to open the chest with an Undaunted key. Beside of other rewards like gold, soul gems and the mercenary style chapters, you can get a monster shoulder piece. Also, you can find in each dungeon special dungeon sets. For dungeons with more than one version, all versions will drop the same dungeon sets. The mini bosses will drop either hand, waist or feet set pieces. Bosses will drop chest, shoulder or leg pieces. Final bosses will drop jewelry, weapon and shield pieces. Random enemies have a slight chance to drop jewelry, and treasure chests in the dungeons have a small chance to drop an armor piece. It is important to know that all dungeon sets are bind on pickup, but tradable to your group for 2 hours. Items dropped in veteran dungeons will always be of epic quality, and items dropped in normal dungeons will always be of superior quality. I will show you now which questgiver offers which dungeon and which monster and dungeon sets you can find in each dungeon. Be aware that you can find monster sets in light, medium, heavy and in various traits. Maja'ar Ragat will offer you following pledges. The Banished Cells are in Auridon. Here you can collect following dungeon sets. The Sanctuary set, the Jailbreaker set and the Tormentor set. As monster sets you can find in Banished Cells 1 the Shadowrun set and in Banished Cells 2 the Maw of the Infernal set. The Darkshade Caverns are in Deshan. Here you can collect following dungeon sets. Nedge's Touch, Armor of Truth and the Strength of Automaton set. As monster sets you can find in Darkshade Caverns 1 the Sentinel of Rukmas set and in Darkshade Caverns 2 the Engine Guardian set. The Elden Hollow Dungeon is in Gradwood. Here you can collect following dungeon sets. Lightspeaker, Barkskin and the Undaunted Bastion set. As a monster set you can find in Elden Hollow 1 the Chokethorn set and in Elden Hollow 2 the Nightflame set. The Fungal Grotto is located in Stonefalls. Here you can collect following dungeon sets. Cultist Cowl, Draug Kingslayer and the Viper's Sting set. As monster sets you can find in Fungal Grotto 1 the Krax set and in Fungal Grotto 2 the Spawn of Mephala set. The Spindleklatsch Dungeon is in Glenumbra. You can collect following dungeon sets. Prayer Shawl, Spelunke and the Nightmare set. As monster sets you can find in Spindleklatsch 1 the Swarm Mother set and in Spindleklatsch 2 the Bloodspawn set. The various sewers are in Stormhaven. Here you can collect following dungeon sets. Combat Physician, Tooth Throw and the Surgeon's Maze set. As monster sets you can find in various sewers 1 the Slime Core set and in various sewers 2 the Scourge Harvester set. Glirion the Redbeard will offer you following pledges. The Arx Chronium Dungeon is in Shadowfen. Here you can collect following dungeon sets. Lamia Song, Medusa and the Undaunted Infiltrator set. As monster set you can find in Arx Chronium the Celestrix set. Blackheart Haven is in Bankorei. Here you can collect following dungeon sets. Undaunted Unweaver, Bone Pirate's Tatters and a Knight Errant's Maze set. As monster set you can find in Blackheart Haven the Pirate Skeleton set. The Blessed Crucible is in the Rift. Here you can collect following dungeon sets. Noble Duelist Silks, Sword Dancer and the Nicholas Heavy Armor set. As monster set you can find in Blessed Crucible the Troll King set. The City of Ash is in Greenshade. Here you can collect following dungeon sets. Burning Spellreef, Thunderflame and the Ember Shield set. As monster sets you can find in City of Ash 1 the Infernal Guardian set and in City of Ash 2 the Vulcan Scoria set. The Crypt of Hearts is in Rivenspire. Here you can collect following dungeon sets. Shroud of the Lich, Leviathan and the Ebon Armor set. As monster sets you can find in Crypt of the Hearts 1 the Lampris set and in Crypt of the Hearts 2 the Nirineth set. The Direforce Keep is in Eastmarch. Here you can collect following dungeon sets. Magica Furnace, Dwarger Hulk and the Ice Furnace set. As monster sets you can find in the Direforce Keep the Ice Heart set. The Selene's Web Dungeon is in Reaper's March. Here you can collect following dungeon sets. Vestments of the Warlock, the Scene's Veneer and the Duroc's Bane set. As monster set you can find in Selene's Web the Selene set. Tempest Island is in Malabar Tor. Here you can collect following dungeon sets. Overwhelming Surge, Shock Master and the Jolting Arms set. As monster set you can find in Tempest Island the Stormfist set. The Vaults of Madness is in Cold Harbor. Here you can collect following dungeon sets: Worm's Payment, Oblivion's Edge, and the Battle Cage set. As monster sets, you can find in the Vaults of Madness the Quoth Dar set. Bolenfell is in Alikir Desert. Here you can collect following dungeon sets: Treasure Hunter, Crusader, and the Dune Super Scale set. As monster set, you can find in Volenfell the Tremor Scale set. Ugalak Chiefbane will offer you 4 pledges. Be aware that you need for these dungeons the Imperial City DLC and a Shadow of the Hiss DLC. The Cradle of Shadows dungeon is in Shadowfen. Here you can collect following dungeon sets: Gossamar, Widowmaker, and the Hand of Mephala set. As monster set, you can find in the Cradle of Shadows the Willitreth set. The Ruins of Mazatun are in Shadowfen. Here you can collect following dungeon sets: Emberplassen, Himshas Retribution, and the Aspect of Mazatun set. As monster set, you can find in the Ruins of Mazatun the Mighty Kudan set. The Imperial City Prison is in the Imperial City. Here you can collect following dungeon sets: Skating Mage, Sheer Venom, and the Leeching Plate set. As monster set, you can find in the Imperial City Prison the Lord Warden set. The White Gold Tower is in the Imperial City. Here you can collect following dungeon sets: Spell Power Cure, Ascense Thief, and the Brands of the Imperium set. As monster set, you can find in the White Gold Tower the Molakina set. If you play on PC, I can recommend you the add-on Itemization Browser. This great add-on provides you in-game an overview about all available sets and where you can acquire them. Also, you have many search filters if you are looking for a specific set, type, bonus or dungeon. I will place the link for the Itemization Browser add-on in the description. Hopefully, you enjoyed my overview about the group dungeons, the sets, and the undaunted pledges and rewards in the Elder Scrolls Online. It would be wonderful if you subscribe, like, or leave me a comment. Thanks for watching, have a good day, and until next time, tschüss!